the heck just happened to the stock of Lam Research today? I mean, this company, which is the best semiconductor capital equipment maker I know, had been on fire. And the stocks rallied roughly 60% for the year going into last night's close. Demand for chips is off the charts, and semiconductor companies need Lam's equipment if they want to expand their production capacity. But then Lam Research reported last night, and I loved it. The quarter seemed very strong. Stock nevertheless got knocked around today, sinking $3.58, more than 2% after one point being down $6. So is this simply the kind of confused and irrational move you tend to get at the height of earnings season? Or maybe something we should be worried about? Lam delivered an 8-cent earnings beat off of a $3.03 basis, higher than expected revenue up 9%. Year over year, that's amazing, and very robust guidance for the next quarter. And they also repurchased more than $500 million worth of stock during this period. In short, this was, a lot to like quarter, which is why the stock initially opened much higher. Then the whole technology cohort went to a tailspin this afternoon. Biggest winners succumbed to a wave of profit-taking. Could this be the pullback that makes it for a total gift for you? Let's check in with Martin Anstice. He's the fabulous president and CEO of Lam Research. Learn more about the quarter and where the company's headed. Mr. Anstice, welcome back to Mad Money.
Jim, thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here, as always.
All right, Martin, I got to tell you, today was the first day where I was saying something really good about your company, and a person stopped me and said, listen, I'm in the tech business. That's the most cyclical company on earth. Don't you see that you're going to get caught at the top? I argued that your equipment is what you need to make chips for the new society, Internet of Things, for artificial intelligence, for autonomous driving. Could you settle the debate for me?
You know, I should begin today because, to your point, the performance of the company in the last several years and certainly the most recent quarter and the guidance for the year is truly outstanding, and we're super pleased. I want to say thank you to all of the employees that work extremely hard to make that possible and for the customers for giving us opportunity. I think relative to your cyclicality statements, you know, the last 5 years we delivered pretty healthy growth, 20% or so each year on average. And this year, in the context of the guidance we gave yesterday and the outlook for the December quarter, we should have growth around the 50% level for shipments. So super performance. And relative to sustainability, this is a demand statement. And so as best we can tell, when we look at our customers and the actions that they're taking, the investments they're making, it looks very disciplined, it looks sustainable, and a super exciting time for the world of tech.
Can you explain to people the demand for flash and why it's not just for the kinds of things that it's not just consumer flash that's driving everything?
Yeah. I mean, something incredible happened in the last couple of years. The semiconductor industry delivered to the world a level of connectivity, a level of storage and memory and advanced computation to truly harness the value of data, the new currency of the world. And the world of flash memory particularly is a major contributor to that. And as I said yesterday, in the context of the vertical structures, the high-rise structures that are relevant to that memory, it's a sweet spot for the company. And that's one of the fundamental reasons why performance for Lam is as strong as it is. You know, that supports a very diverse set of applications, whether it's autonomous driving, augmented reality, the world of AI and ML. I mean, there's a huge amount of innovation, and the world of silicon, the semiconductor industry, and Lam is sitting right at the center of making that possible.
Now, there are not a lot of companies that directly compete with you anymore. The equipment is much more complex. The chips that they make from your equipment is much more complex. Is it possible that what's happened is that something like a flash, which we thought of as a commodity, is no longer a commodity because it keeps getting better and better and better and more specialized?
No, I think that's absolutely true. I mean, these devices are truly extremely complex technology solutions with great economics. And, you know, the world of vertical scaling, which is really kind of, to use a real estate analogy, a transition from single house, single level structures to high rise, you know, is all about atomic level scaling, and it's all about aspect ratio scaling, tall and narrow structures with hugely complex yields and defect challenges, patent collapse challenges, and Lam Research is a real specialist at responding to all of that. And you know, we feel delighted with performance and really proud of the opportunity for the company in the years ahead.
All right, I hate to have you be the foil, but you're the best I know, so I'm giving it to you. So then other people come back and say, Jim, it's 2000 all over again. And these companies don't make that much money. They don't have that much money. They're selling at 40 times earnings. Their balance sheets are bad. You are selling at 13 times earnings. If I'm not wrong, you've got something like $30 per share offshore that you can't even do anything with because we have such a bad tax code, and that this is the most flush that Lam Research has ever been.
Well, you know, as I said probably a couple of times before, we focus on the things we control. We focus on the differentiation of the company, the trust we're building with customers, the fit of the product portfolio to the technology inflections of our customers. That's where our focus and energies are, operational execution and scaling. And we trust over time the valuation takes care of itself relative to public policy and tax code, obviously. Repatriation, tax reform are high on the list of kind of interests for us. And certainly, I think Lam is highly leveraged to that as and when it plays out.
All right, terrific, Martin. Hey, look, congratulations. It was a monster quarter. I just felt the pain today. I said, I got to go to a guy who really understands the business because your numbers were just superior. Thank you so much for being on the show.
Super, Jim. Thank you very much.
All right, that's Martin Anstice, the president and CEO of Lam Research. Look, can stocks go down? They're doing well. Of course they can. But Lam is inexpensive, doing a great job, and Martin's one of the best there is. Jim Cramer. Booyah! Jim Cramer here from Mad Money. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube. Click here to subscribe and get the jump on my exclusives with CEOs, plus market news, investing advice, and a whole lot more.